1994, by Richard Turner and William Osborne, with Robert Lindsay as Edward, Siobhan Redmond as Sophie, and Paul Shearer as Charles. Episode 1, Work is Freedom.
Shut up, alarm clock.
Sorry.
What time is it?
I thought you said shut up.
Oh, look, don't get like that.
It will be 9, 10 and 20 seconds, Tuesday, 4th January. Now.
You're such a pedant.
No, I'm not. You're failing to make the fine distinction between mere pedantry and accuracy. I am accurate to within 1 millisecond every 100 years. I see no reason why I should waste my valuable and near-perfectly monitored time by saying it's about 9:10.
Clever you may be, but you're still just an alarm clock.
A cat may look at a king.
Even if you are over-educated.
Well, you bought me. Got out of bed the wrong side this morning, didn't we?
Well, you should know.
Television.
Can I be of service?
Try Channel 5.
I do not recommend it. Until the day that you die.
17!
Uraganach, Erlanerly William Seagok, Arflanalivida Gogok, Early Warning Systems. Barumenin, a cause, a gwilym, a clap of mountain missile silos.
10.
Amalgamated Incorporations, the government-sponsored company which manufactures domestic all-purpose robots that we all know more commonly as Fetchers, has announced the launch of the new Mark 7 Fetcher. This model, they assure us, is completely stable and will not fall over, as did Marks 1 to 6.
And finally, there has been another breach of security in the highly restricted earthquake zone of Cumbria.
Oh, that's enough.
I have got a film on 3.
No, not now.
Is there any other way I can be of service to you?
No.
Sayonara.
Fetcher?
Yes?
Get the post, please, Fetcher. And don't make that noise.
Sorry. I've fallen over.
Oh, I'll get it then. Right. What have we got here? Bill. Bill. Postcard. Video card.
Alarm clock.
Yes, television.
Have you all noticed how he talks to himself?
First signs of madness.
That'll be the telephone.
Yes, I know.
Hello?
Hello?
Mr. Wilson?
Yes, speaking.
Good morning. I'm phoning from the environment. You have an interview with us at 4 o'clock today, and I'm just ringing to confirm it.
Oh, yes. Yes, of course. Yes, I'll be there.
You'd forgotten, hadn't you?
No, I hadn't.
Well, you looked surprised when I told you.
No, I didn't. I was just opening my mail when the phone rang.
Good Lord. Do people still send letters? I haven't even got a letterbox. Your room's in a tip, isn't it? 4 o'clock, then.
Yes, 4 o'clock, then.
Oh, and don't think I'm being rude, but I'd have a shave if I were you. A bit blue round the chin.
Yes, I've only just got up.
Well, that explains it. Well, these are your pyjamas, then, are they? Can't tell these days. 4 o'clock, then. Yeah.
Goodbye. What a nerve. Fridge, what have I got for breakfast?
Well, I'm running low on just about everything at the moment. And the milk's gone off. Not the Slimmer's vitamin B12 stuff, that can't go off in a million years, but the normal stuff's getting very smelly. And when are you going to defrost me?
Oh, never mind. Television? Excuse me. Oh, sorry. Is this the environment?
What do you mean, is this the environment?
I mean, is this the environment? The Department of the Environment?
You mean this massive concrete and glass building here with Department of Environment in 10-foot-high letters on the side?
Ah.
Yes, it is. And that's a door. And if you go through it, you'll find yourself inside.
Oh, thank you. Sorry. Hello, reception.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the environment. Can I help you?
Yes, I've got an interview at 4 o'clock.
Which department?
The Department of the Environment.
Which department of the Department of the Environment? There's the Agriculture Department, the Treasury Department, the Foreign Department, the Employment Department, the Home Department.
I don't really know.
The environment is very big. But try the fourth floor today. Most of the interviews are held there.
Thank you. Excuse me. My name's Edward Wilson. Sorry I'm late, I got lost.
The environment is very big. What did you want? I'm Sophie.
Oh, sorry, I'm Edward Wilson. I got an appointment at 4. Is this the interview room?
No, Mr. Wilson. That's it, over there.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, don't go in yet. They're not...
No, don't talk to me.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Edward Wilson, 4 o'clock, late, lost.
Yes. Well, if you wouldn't mind waiting outside, we have a few things to discuss.
Oh, sorry, I thought I was late.
Well, let's just pretend you were early, shall we?
I tried to warn you, Edward. Sit down and have a chat with Sophie.
I really don't think he's our man.
Let's take a look at his records then, shall we?
Well, there you are. 27 years of age, no previous jobs, personal details on the left. Ah. Medical, social, theological, psychological, bank account.
Mm. In the red, I see.
HP payments not too large, pays more or less regularly.
Voted the right way last time.
Yes, but look at that by-election vote in 86.
Yes, but that was the year of the difficulties, wasn't it?
I don't think we have to dwell on that.
When did he last have a girlfriend?
Yeah, here it is. Girl called Diana, red hair, about a year ago.
Nice girl.
How do you know that?
It says NG after her name.
Oh, always thought that meant no good.
Well, let's see what went wrong with that particular relationship.
Oh, nothing juicy, I'm afraid. Usual story. He misunderstood her needs and she wouldn't pay the phone bill.
I bet she was the sort who spent hours on the phone. Oh, I could see it all.
C of E, no religion anyway.
Family. Oh, yes. Father, I remember him, negotiator for ACAS, who died in the course of duty in 86.
Difficult year for negotiating.
Yeah, well, negotiators weren't armed in those days.
That's the basic framework. No need to pry into the personal details. Let's have him in.
Show Mr. Wilson in, please, Sophie.
Oh, you can go in now, Edward. Good luck.
Well, now, Edward, isn't it?
Yes, Edward.
So, Edward, tell us all about yourself.
Well, there's not a lot to tell, actually.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
Well, I mean, I really want the job. I think it would suit me. I've got the right temperament, I think.
And what kind of temperament is that, Edward?
Well, I'm level-headed. That's not to say I don't have a bit of flair from time to time. I mean, I can think on my feet.
Oh, good.
And do sit down, Edward.
Oh, thank you.
Now, Edward, any questions from you?
Yes. What is the job, exactly?
Well, I think it's a little premature.
Yes, it's best to get the job first, then find out. If we knew exactly what the job was, we'd be doing it ourselves, wouldn't we?
Oh, yes. Yes, it's early days for knowing exactly what you'll be getting up to.
Oh, I see. Right. Yes. Exactly.
If you'd like to wait outside, we'll call you back in. We have a few things to discuss.
Boom, 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 boom.
Better get him back in here, I suppose.
Oh, him? Oh, yes, yes. Let's see what the mainframe says.
Okay.
That's it? Good Lord. Send him back in, Sophie.
Oh, Edward. All right. You can have him back. But don't keep him for too long.
Well, Edward, you've got the job.
What? Well, just like that? Thank you. When do I start?
The job's yours. Start when you like. Come and go as you please. Obviously, it'll take you a while to find your feet and to get to know the place. We're a big ministry. We're getting bigger and bigger ever since we were privatised. The environment is very big, as they say. Take your time and don't do anything rash for a few days.
You see, I've never had a job before.
It's best not to do anything for a few days. Keep a low profile, that's the best policy. And we need some personal details, so drop into the office.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.